Hi, I'm Rick Clow, one of the product managers on Blogger, and I'll be walking you through the migration tool that will help migrate your FTP blog over to Blogger hosting. We announced this tool a few weeks ago. We've been busy nailing down a couple of details to ensure that this is a fairly smooth process that will ensure that any blogs you're currently publishing via FTP will be able to be updated after we shut down support for FTP on May 1st. So when you log into Blogger starting today, you'll notice an alert at the top of your dashboard indicating that FTP support is going away on May 1st. And you'll be invited to start the migration by clicking the Start Migration Now link. You'll also have a link here to the dedicated FTP blog, which presumably many of you have already seen from recent emails that have gone out about this announcement. So when we click Start Migration, this will take us to what we're calling the FTP Migration Dashboard. Here you'll see a list of all of your FTP blogs. In this case, I have just one, but if you have others, they'll be listed here as well. In the lower left is a video, which will be this video as soon as it's done, and it will be embedded there in the lower left. And then on the right are the headlines from the FTP blog, as we have any other announcements to make, clarifications to make. In the coming weeks, they'll be added to the FTP blog and be linked to from this migration dashboard. So we go ahead and click Start. That takes us to the first step in the migration process. Here we see something that we just recommend in general is good hygiene for any blogger, which is to get a backup of your blog. In this case, we want to take a full backup. This includes all your posts, all your comments, your template, to ensure that should anything go wrong at this point, we don't expect it to, but if it does, we have a full backup to allow us to recover the blog contents without any data loss. So we're going to go ahead and click Download Blog Backup so that we have that full XML file on our hard drive. Click OK, and this will save the file to our hard drive. Once we've done that, then it's time to continue and actually start the migration. So now we're going to click on Continue. That'll take us to step two, where we have to pick our new URL for the blog. Now, in this case, the migration tool gives you two options. You can either host your blog at Blogspot, or you can host your blog at the domain you're currently hosting your FTP blog at. We assume most of you are going to want to keep your domain's branding in the URL of the blog. So we're going to walk you through the process of migrating from an FTP blog to a Blogger custom domain. In this case, we've already filled in the domain that you're currently hosting at. We've selected a subdomain, and we're going to go ahead and click Continue. This will take us to the next screen where we have to verify that the subdomain is set up properly. And there's a link here for those of you that need to know how to set up a CNAME on your domain. Generally a fairly straightforward process, just quick chat with your domain registrar. We have detailed instructions in our help form that walk you through how to do that with most popular registrars. In my case, I had already done this ahead of setting up this migration so that this video would be a little bit more streamlined. Because I've done that, DNS has already propagated. Requests for yeoldftp.rcloud.com, the subdomain I've selected, are already being pointed to Google's servers. So as soon as that DNS has propagated, you'll see in this box a hosted by Blogger message. That indicates that your subdomain is properly configured and that we are seeing requests for your domain, which means at that point we can continue. If you don't see that right away, that may mean it's taking a few minutes for DNS to propagate. You can always leave and come back. Just click Resume from the Migration Dashboard. It'll bring you back here. Now we're almost done. Your new blog URL is already set up. Requests that go to that domain are already working. Your blog is live at that address. But of course, you've been publishing perhaps for years to another URL, your FTP URL, and you want to make sure that all of the backlinks that are pointing to those old posts flow through to the new site. You want to make sure that search traffic, when people search for terms about on posts that you've written, that those search queries result in traffic to the new blog. And you want to make sure that anyone who clicks a link to an old post finds the new URL. We do two things. We use something called rel equals canonical. That is simply some code that gets inserted into the HTML of the page that tells search engines where the right or canonical page is on the internet. In this case, it's the new URLs are the canonical locations for your blog pages. And meta refresh simply redirects visitors to the older pages, the old FTP pages, by redirecting in the browser after a few seconds. That ensures that they are transported from the old pages to the new and get the benefit of whatever design updates you've done in the new blog, whatever new content you've posted to the new blog post-migration. Now, this process may take a while, right? We're doing a full FTP republish of your blog. And if you don't want to stick around and sit and watch a spinner indicate that an FTP is happening, we'll give you the option of checking a box and being emailed when the migration is complete. Check the box, type in your email address, click Start Update, and this will kick off a full FTP republish of your entire blog, which will then add the code that we've just mentioned above to every page on your blog, ensuring that we are protecting those backlinks, we are preserving that search traffic, we are preserving any click traffic from external blogs at other websites coming through to your new blog URL. Now, in this case, this isn't a very big blog. This update only takes about 20 seconds. Yours, of course, may take a little bit longer depending on how big your blog is and how fast the connection to your FTP host is. As soon as it's done, you'll both get an email and see on this screen that the FTP republish has completed. We'll click Continue, and that'll take us to the very last step of this process, which is checking a few of the old FTP URLs, looking for the code that we inserted in those pages to make sure that the redirects are in place, to make sure that the refresh, the meta refresh tag that we inserted, is also in place. As soon as we do that, we know that the FTP URLs properly point to your new URL, which will help ensure that within the next day or two, Google will have indexed all your new URLs, and any visitors to the old pages on the FTP blog will come through to your new URL. As soon as you see that verification successful message, you're presented with an option to click Finish, which will mark your blog as done and update its status in the FTP migration dashboard. You'll now see, of course, that your post will appear immediately. And for more on what's new on Blogger, since you were set up on FTP, you can also click that link. You'll see here in the dashboard, your migration status is complete. You're now done.